age. But back to the album, we're gonna get back into the state of the union in 2 seconds. But this is my joint. I like the classical beginning, then you drop that beat and you get back into talking shit like melody. Like it's no, seriously, I'm really, and the reason why I said I think this is like defining, because I mean the intro, like, I mean y'all cursing, like y'all, and it's not like brash or anything, but you're saying things like I shit or whatever. But my point is you're grown, like, and you fit, I feel growth in this, like musically, just like all the talents. I mean, clearly everyone knows how talented you are when you play instruments and you do the octet, but yeah, it sounds like a thing.
Thank you. That's, again.
I hope I'm meshing all the things together. I'm just trying, I hope you feel that energy, because defining yourself at 20 and 22 musically, I mean, sky's the limit from here.
Thank you so much. Yeah, I feel like as we grow as individuals, the music will grow with us, because, you know, we put our hearts and souls into the music. So I'm happy that you hear that naturally.
Yeah, it's crazy. But this song right here, child, I mean, it just makes me happy. I want us all types to move. I don't know what woe shit y'all doing, but I'm with all that. Yes, this record right here is special. I'll be my Taking pictures, make sure you can see no less. Oh, and my 16-year-old son, by the way, says he remembers y'all for the first time in Let It Shine. Does that ring a bell?
Oh, oh yeah. Yeah, that's when we first met Trevor.
That's crazy.
Years and years ago.
Yeah, my son Kyle Burns, he wants to send you guys some merch, but I'll get it to you. But he said, yeah, I remember them from Let It Shine. I was like, what? Oh, what was that? I don't remember Let It Shine. That I thought would find and felt like the growth for you guys musically. And it showed messages for women through your music. You know, you obviously are securing your offering, which is very important. But then also America is on fire right now. And I just, you know, I'm light-skinned. That clearly means somebody in my tree was white. I'm having issues just in general, but I'm glad that white people are standing up for black people in a way, because, you know, white people, like those types of white people are like, you know, going away. I feel like the Trumps, that whole, they're 70, 80, they're almost gone. The kids are dating all types of racists. So hopefully we can clean up the racism, but then I'm scared of classism. But I want to know how y'all feel on the state of America today.
Yes. Well, of course, there's such uncertainty right now. Everybody, we're all up in arms. We don't know what to do. This pandemic, of course, you know, the Black Lives Matter movement is definitely something that is positive that's coming out of this. I mean, we are Black women. We have seen this since the beginning of our lives. None of this is new to us. Our brothers and sisters dying is not new to us. It's horrible. But this has been happening for a very long time. And now, people are finally rallying together to try and do something about it. And, you know, all we can do right now, we're trying to be hopeful instead of angry, because sometimes being, you have so much emotion, being a Black woman and taking on all of this trauma of your family, seeing your family die, like, of course, that's, it makes you angry. It makes you sad. It makes you just want to just do something about it. And, what we're trying to do is use our gift, use what God has given us to make a change for the better, lift people up through our voices, heal with our song, anything that we can do, because this has been happening for a long time. But we're so proud to be a part of this generation, because I feel like this generation is not scared. We're not scared to stand up for what we believe in. We're not scared to shout it from the rooftops and say, this is wrong. We need to do something about it. And yeah, we're just glad to be a part of it and doing something, doing everything that we can to make a difference. So of course, the current state of the world is not the best, like we would all want it to be. Of course, we want racism to go away. We just have to all work towards it and work towards doing something about it. And right now, we're really hopeful.
That's dope. Your energy is everything. Hallie, so Chloe, what do you think about voting? Voting, I mean, you know, clearly you both are old enough. And I think that a lot of times people don't really understand, especially young, the importance of local, state, and federal, which local is like your DAs, your police, your judges, da-da-da, state, so forth and so on, and obviously federal with the president. See, are you guys interested in getting involved in that? If so, are you doing anything?
Absolutely. The last term was when it was my first time to vote. And even though the outcome didn't happen and turn out what I wanted it to be, right, I was still happy that I was able to use my voice as a Black woman, because our ancestors have fought for that right, and we don't take it lightly when it comes to voting. And I'm so happy we can actually vote together this year. And I feel like all of our brothers and sisters, the whole entire world, we need to vote, because that's how we really make our voices heard. So I feel like it's truly important, you know?
That's awesome. And so I had a little thing yesterday, because I've known Kanye for a very long time. Actually, when I met my wife, I'll be married 21 years.
Great. Congrats. When's your anniversary?
October 16th.
Come on, you do it. Nice. That's what I'm saying. Okay.
Yeah. If I forget that out, it's going to be no dinner. It's Taco Tuesday. I want my tacos. But, you know, I was listening to Kanye, and I've always, and I want to know your opinion on this, but I've always supported Kanye's genius, and I still do. The man's a genius. I mean, he's doing things that are unfathomable, right? And are now fathomable. But I think that, you know, him throwing out that he's going to run for office in 2020 with 4 months left, when we clearly have two candidates that people are trying to get behind or not. What do y'all think about that?
What do you think about it?
Child, I think that, I made a statement yesterday. I told him, you know, I think people react in life based on past experiences. Act on now. Like Kanye of 20 years ago is not the same Kanye. You've grown, you suffered loss, you've gone through things that should have you on an even playing field mentally. And I just feel like, you know, I don't think it's propaganda, because I think he really wants to run for president. I don't think he's ready, nor has he proved he's selfless enough. You know, we've seen what happens in office now, like with people like Trump. There's no filter. Like, there's no allegiance. There's no alliance. He don't care about his own people. I mean, he's fired and hired more, you know, staff than any president in history. So I'm kind of disappointed that he would do it now, because I really believe in him. I really think that he could do something great. But, you know, it's hard to fight for him when he keeps doing things like this.
I just hope that I can always be the best version of myself. And that's my number one thing. Every time I wake up, it's how can I better myself, you know?
Right. Got it. All right. Didn't want to touch that one. I feel you. These comments, your followers, wow, they're very nice. Here. And they go in. Yeah. Well, I just want to tell you guys, artists that get it, that understand their purpose, that, you know, can really contribute to, you know, society in the way that you guys are so early. And I just want to applaud you for that. I think, you know, it's a special thing to not only be writing and producing at this age, but acting and then having a voice for Black women. So I wish you the best. I know that, you know, your futures will be bright. And the next time we get together, child, it's going to be on TV. You know, Chaz got me an offer. I'm going to let y'all know about it later. I'm not leaving the bobbleheads. I'm not leaving, and I need Chloe and Hallie bobbleheads. But yeah, so I salute you guys.
With locks too.
You have them?
No, we need the ones with the locks, the bobbleheads with the locks.
You got it. So that's your hello, Sony. What's the name of the label?
Columbia and Parkwood. Yeah.
Parkwood. We need Chloe and Hallie, bobbleheads ASAP. So please, yeah, get that. I'll have them. So the next time you come, Parkwood, get me. Aziz, I need those ASAP. But yeah, love to you guys. Love to your families. And thank you for spending some time with me on the Kenny Byrne Show.
Thank you so much. Have a good day. Many blessings.
Okay, peace. Yeah, love those girls. Please follow them if you don't already. And more importantly, support and protect our Black women at all costs. Salute to their parents. They did a phenomenal job. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Loner is on tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, Loner, one of my favorite new artists. He's so dope. He's on tomorrow. Stay tuned. It's the Kenny Burns Show. Peace.